DBT is a powerful tool for data transformation within the data warehouse. However, it does come with some limitations. Firstly, with DBT Core, it is not possible to preview the outputs of a model before building it, which can hinder the ability to validate and iterate on the data transformation process. Secondly, since SQL is DBT's primary language, performing complex feature engineering tasks can be challenging without the aid of additional tools or languages like Python. Lastly, while DBT excels in data transformation, it does not provide a comprehensive end-to-end solution for tasks like data loading, data extraction, and orchestration. We can effectively address these challenges with the DBT Mage integration. Mage is an open source data pipeline tool for data transformation and integration tasks. It seamlessly complements DBT by delivering multiple benefits. Firstly, Mage provides a convenient web-based IDE where you can develop and explore data models effortlessly within a single interface. Secondly, with Mage, you can combine the strengths of different tools and languages. Thirdly, Mage provides a built-in visualization capability, allowing users to effortlessly visualize the output generated by DBT models with just a few clicks. In addition to data transformation, Mage offers functionalities for data extraction and loading. Lastly, Mage allows you to schedule your data pipelines and automatically retry failed components. Let's dive deeper into each of these features. Mage offers a user-friendly web-based UI that simplifies the creation of DBT models. Its unique feature of using blocks allows for interactive code development, similar to working in a Jupyter notebook. Each block functions as an independent executable code file. To create a new DBT model, click on DBT Model, New Model, and provide the name and the location of the model. Write your query and click Compile and Preview to preview the query results. Execute the model by clicking the three-dot icon and selecting Run Model. From the log, we can see that the run completed successfully. You can create additional models within the same editor by clicking DBT Model again. Now we have two models, Staging Trips and Staging Stations. Mage empowers you to combine DBT models with other languages, including Python, R, or SQL, for data loading, transformation, and exporting purposes. For example, we can create a Python data loader block by clicking on Data Loader, then selecting Python and choosing Generic. Name this as LoadUS. Next, replace the code inside the LoadData function with the appropriate code to load the US data. Additionally, we have the option to include code for testing the output of the block. Afterward, we can create another data loader to load the data for India. We will then add a DBT block to join the outputs of these data loaders. Set the parent blocks of join tables by clicking Edit Parent Blocks and clicking the data loader blocks. Save dependencies. Since the DBT model depends on non-DBT upstream block, Mage automatically adds the source for that block to the Mage sources.yaml file. You can now use the outputs of the Python blocks within the DBT block by using the source function. Specify the name of the source and the table name as arguments to access the desired data. Next, we can create a transformer block called convert object to integer that converts specific columns from the output of the upstream block into integers. And here is the output after the run. Another benefit of using Mage is the ability to visualize DBT model output. While traditional tools like Tableau can be used for visualization, Mage offers a consolidated solution for processing and analyzing the output of a DBT block in one place. To create a time series line chart, click the Add Chart icon and select Time Series Line Chart. Select Time Column, Matrix, and you will see the following line chart. Mage also enables you to schedule pipeline runs and incorporates a retry mechanism for failed blocks without rerunning the entire pipeline. To execute a pipeline immediately, click the triggers icon on the left panel and select Run Pipeline Now. To monitor the real-time status of all block runs, choose the newly created pipeline trigger and click See Block Runs. The log shows the block type, creation time, and status of each block run, making it easy to monitor the progress of the blocks. To schedule a pipeline, click Triggers, Create New Trigger, select Schedule, and define the desired frequency. In this case, let's select Daily Frequency. Select Save Changes and Start Trigger. Now our pipeline will execute on a daily basis. If you want to retry incomplete blocks without restarting the entire pipeline, click Retry Incomplete Blocks. This feature ensures that only the necessary blocks are retried, minimizing unnecessary repetition. While Mage is a great complement to DBT, it's important to consider a few drawbacks when using Mage. Firstly, integrating both Mage and DBT can introduce additional complexity to the structure of your project. Secondly, since Mage wraps extra code around the block code, error messages tend to be lengthier compared to standard error messages. Thirdly, while Mage provides an intuitive user experience, like any tool, getting acquainted with this new tool will require some time and effort. In summary, Mage is an ideal tool to complement your DBT project if you seek improved efficiency and are open to a slight increase in project complexity. If you'd like to learn how to set up Mage and build a pipeline, explore the code and article provided in the description below. After your machine learning pipeline is built, automating code and model testing become crucial for reproducibility and accelerating decision making. In this next video, you will learn how to create a CI pipeline for a machine learning project.